always good to hear from you. What's up?
Well, I really never got the chance to thank you for helping clear Spinelli.
Oh, well, you know, I really didn't do much.
Yeah, you did. You got the flash drive. Without that, he'd be in prison right now.
Well, this is the thing. When I heard they were going over to the FBI headquarters to break into the hard drive, I kind of went because I was afraid they were going to get caught.
Yeah, they would have. And you know Spinelli has no idea how to bluff anybody.
Yeah, I suppose his people skills might be lacking.
Exactly, exactly. And that's why he should partner with you in a detective agency.
He told you about that?
Told, yeah. This kid is so excited about it, but I know it takes, money to start a new business. So
it's a good thing I saved enough.
No, this is just for Spinelli's share of the startup costs. And anything else you guys need to get this business going.
I don't feel right.
No, it's only to cover Spinelli's half. You guys have to rent offices, get new computers, all the latest equipment.
Yeah, you seem really eager to get us started.
Well, I just think you guys are gonna make a great team.
Okay, that's fine. I mean, Spinelli said the same thing. He thinks our skills complement each other. I don't know. I was kind of hesitant at first, but I really do want my PI license. Mm-hmm. And, gosh, I haven't really thought about taking on a partner.
Well, you couldn't do better than Spinelli.
He is a computer genius.
Yeah, and he's honest. He's loyal. He works hard. You guys get along, right? And trust me, he is highly motivated to make this work.
Yeah, he is. I mean, now that you put it that way, I don't know. I think he would make a perfect partner.
Good. Whoa. No,
what?
I think there's just a few things that you need to, be aware of, okay?
Okay.
Spinelli is going to want to use a gun. No. You keep your guns out of his sight.
Absolutely.
Okay, don't let him drive your car either. He is absolutely the worst driver on planet Earth.
Got it.
Okay, stakeout. If you're going on one, you might want to think twice because he has the patience of a gnat and he likes to talk and move and chew chips in your ears and he just doesn't sit still.
Okay, it's fine. I was planning on doing all the field work myself anyway, so that's fine.
Perfect, good idea. He gets seasick too. And he thinks he knows martial arts, but he doesn't really know martial arts.
I mean, fine. I could get a little dizzy.
Yeah, I could. But you know what? The best way to distract him is just get him on the computer because you said he's a genius. He will find anybody. But I just don't want him to get in any more trouble with the FBI.
Again. I agree. I mean, I couldn't agree with you more, actually. Okay, I mean, if you want to offer anything else, I don't know, maybe stock up the place with chips and orange soda because it is brain food. He can't function without it.
Yeah, he can't really. I'll take care of whatever you guys need.
Thank you. It's actually really very sweet, the way you care about him.
Yeah, well, he's not too good at taking care of himself.
I don't have to worry because I promise I'll do my best. So, maybe you would like to supervise the opening of the detective agency?
No, that's all yours. I don't want any input.
Well, sure, Spinelli. Or myself might ask for it.
Well, I do appreciate you keeping an eye on Spinelli. Yeah, Carly, what's up?
Jason, I'm with Michael, and I just saw his hand move.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
I tried to call Sonny, but he's in some kind of a meeting, and I don't want to leave a message.
What did the doctor say?
Patrick's checking on him now. It was as clear as day. A couple of his fingers twitched.
He was trying to move his hand.
He's been in a coma for a while. Let's just not jump to any conclusions right now.
Jason, he's been completely immobile, and now he's moving.
He's trying to reach out to us. I know it. I can feel it. Here comes Patrick. I'll call you back as soon as...
Okay, just keep me posted.
Good news about Michael?
I don't know.
Do you think Carly was just imagining Michael's hand moved?
She just wants Michael to wake up so badly. So do I. You know, I would do anything. I would give anything to see Michael come out of this.
All right, well, that's why she called you. She needs your support.
Yeah, I know.
Do you know that it used to drive me crazy when we were together? And every time Carly had a crisis, she would come barging through that door, demanding your full attention, wanting you to drop everything. to make her your top priority.
She counts on me, you know?
Yes, she does, Jason. It's just that now that there's been a lot of distance between us, I actually think it's really great to be able to have somebody who always has your back. And given Michael's situation, I think what Carly needs to hear right now is that you believe her and you feel hopeful,
yeah,
too.
I want to help.
But what?
But what? The doctor said that he's not going to recover. You know, doctors can be wrong. I mean, look at me, my accident. They said that I was a hopeless case. So why should I believe them about Michael?
All right, you are saying that you want to hope. That's not the same as having hope.